Shalom, friends. Just a few moments ago, I finished a 6 mile run and hike and climb up hills, down hills, through ravines, over some snow that is holding on for dear life. But we're in the season of Pesach. We're in the season of Passover. And last night we celebrated the Seder. And in that, you Zecher Yetziat Mitzrayim, you remember the Exodus from Egypt. And now we are in the Zaman Keratenu, the season of our deliverance. As some of you know, the last 21 months or so, I've been renewed in health, and I've been blessed to take off 110 pounds, coming down for 350 pounds, down to 240 pounds now. And I want you to hold on to that for a moment. As we remember this season, as we walk in this season of isolation and social distancing, remember that as the psalmist was reflecting on the Exodus from Egypt in Psalm 105, he says in verse 7 or 37 that there was not one kashal, there was not one feeble among the tribes. When I was 350 pounds and I was there for a long time, let me tell you, there were days, especially if I sat too long or if I woke up in the morning, where I would be fumbling and stumbling and toddling about because my feet, I was trying to reenact that right now, because my feet were in such pain. And it's hurt so bad to stand, and I couldn't stand, and I could barely walk. Well, if you recall a video or so ago, I talked about how the children of Israel wouldn't listen to Moses because they were short of breath. They were out of breath, as we might say today. Now, I couldn't have imagined doing what I had just done 2 years ago, because I wouldn't have had the breath to walk up my driveway, much less do that. But as the children of Israel go into their homes and apply the blood of the Lamb and go to the tables with their loins girded and ready to go, staff in hand, eating, prepared, something happens. As that weight of bondage is lifted off of them and they realize that they're walking into the promise and they have now been set free from bondage, there's a healing that takes place. Where they didn't have the strength to stand previously, and when they walked as a toddle and they waddled and they didn't quite have their feet, what do we call a child as that child is beginning to walk? We call them a toddler. But the psalmist says that there was not one kashal among them. There was not one who was feeble in their feet. There was not one whose legs were weak. But then something happens. After they cross the Red Sea, the armies of Amalek come to attack. Now, while the children of Israel were strong enough to leave, to walk out, and not be feeble and not be weak, some of them were not yet strong enough to fight. In this season of social isolation, social distancing, and this season of global plague, some of us who are in the faith had the wind knocked out of us. And although we are able to stand up and walk with a bit of a limp, let's say, or we're moving, you know, I pray that your gait is recovering. We have to remember that those of us who are stronger in faith at this season, that the Lord will send us back to strengthen those who are a bit weak in faith at this time. Why? Because the army of Amalek is one that is still, and the spirit of Amalek is still in this world, searching for ways to discourage the faithful in order to pull them away from the Lord. And as the Apostle Paul tells us, having done all by applying the armor of God, by putting on the armor of God, what does he tell us to do? Stand. Stand. Now that we have the weight of bondage pulled off of us, we can stand in him. And in him we can face whatever the enemy might bring toward us. But we do it as a body. We do it together. Some days I'll be strong, some days you'll be strong, but all of us together as the body of Messiah will walk out with not one feeble among the tribe. And when we walk out as that strong, united tribe, no army, no enemy, no deceit, no discouragement will be able to overtake us. I pray you found inspiration in this. Chag Sameach Pesach. I pray a joyous and meaningful Passover for each and every one of you. Amen.